हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर। माई सेल्फ मिस्टर मुकुल बरवंत, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, संजीवनी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स साइंस कॉलेज, कोपरगांव। लेट्स सी, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज अ ग्राउंड वाटर एज अ रिसोर्स। यू ऑल नो अबाउट द रिसोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर। वन ऑफ द देम important resource, that is a ground waters. Ground water is the water found underground in the crack and the spaces in the soils, sand and the rock. Such type of water is considered as a ground water. It store and move slowly through a geological formation of soils, sand and the rock is called as aquifers. Aquifers are typically made of gravel, sand, sandstone or the fracture rock like limestone, make them permeables. The speed at which groundwater flow depends on the size of the spaces of the soil, rock and how their spaces are connected. That means related to how the groundwater form from the geological spaces and the formation of that rock through which water will be move. Groundwater can be found almost everywhere. The water table may be deep or shallow and may rise or fall depending on many factors. Heavy rain or melting snow may cause the water table rise or heavy pumping of groundwater supplies may cause the water table falls. That means there is a rise or the falls of groundwater will be take place due to the different reasons. That means if melting, if global warming is more, that water will be a rise, and if global warming will be a decreases, that will be a falling the level of groundwaters. Okay, there are different factors that are responsible for the groundwater. Groundwater supply the replenish or recharge by rain, snow, melt, seeps into crack, crevices and the beneath of land surface. In some areas of the world, people face the serious water shortage because the groundwater is used as faster than the naturally replenish. In other areas, groundwater are polluted by a human activity. That means I have explained previously, groundwater are responsible due to the different activity. Out of one, that is the melting snow, due to which increase or rise or the fall will be take place. And another type of groundwater may be polluted due to the human activity. Let's see total water withdrawal in 2005. Total water, how we can withdraw 2005. Then that means the usage or the consumption of water by the human. First, publicly supply. Publicly supply, there is a 67% water and 33%. Domestic use, 2% of 98% water. Immigration, that is a 42% about the 58%. Then aquaculture or the livestock, 60, 22, industrial, 17, mining, 63, and the thermoelectric plant, 1%. That is nothing but the water can be used by the human. Let's see, groundwater and surface water and water resource conservation. That are the content related to groundwater conservation. In that we have seen, today we are almost all spheres of human activity more water drawn than what actually needed. Due to the carelessness, much of it is wasted, allowed to flow out of a impure state. At many places, enough clean water is no longer available. That is the characteristics of a water. And how, why need a conserve that water? That means the production of water, it is very low, or the and usage, it is a too much amount. So we need to the conserve that specific type of water. However, every year we tend to use to move more water than the actually needed. A little care can be a result to the sustainable saving and a longer life for our resources base or else. The water, thus the save, can be a diverted region where there are a storage or the shortage. Excessive irrigation in a arid and the semi-arid region can cause the salt accumulation in a soil, due to which a crop productivity will be a decline. So there are the one most important factors: due to the water losses, there is a soil productivity effect on the agriculture crop productivity, also the effect ultimately the water resources or the groundwater. On other hand of land contributes the depletion of water along the coastal regions, often leads to the movement of saline sea water into fresh water wells, spoiling water quality, and the estuary become more saline, consequently less productive when the surface water are overdrawn. When surface water are coming out from their that surface and groundwater comes in that surface area, due to which salinity of water will be increased. That means saline condition will be increases more. In absence of plant cover, most of the rainwater flows down quickly streams and rivers. Little percolate down the subsurface layer, which recharge the groundwater stocks with a rapidly flowing water. Considerable amount of topsoil is lost with a terrestrial flow of water. In a number of localities where the underground water is regularly drawn, the water tables receding deeper, thus the output exceed the input. Water conservation include all the policies, strategies and activities made up of sustainably manage the natural resources, fresh water, to protect the water environment and meet the current and future human demand. Population, household size, growth, affluence all affect how much water are used. Factors such as the climate change have increased the pressure on natural water resources, especially in manufacturing, agriculture, irrigation. Many US cities have been already implemented policy aimed to the water conservation with much success. So that is a human are using much amount of water than it's needed. So one day we have to face the problems like a water shortage, and due to the different purposes, different activity are responsible to that. So climate change may be a pollution, may be a anything will be a responsible. Then water resource, how water resource and water how can act as a resource. Water conservation is the use of management of water for a good of all consumer. It is used in agriculture, industry and home. Human requirement for the agriculture production, flood control, fish and wildlife management, navigation, industrial production and many other uses have amended to natural hydrological process. That is known as a groundwater as a resource. The hydrospheres refer as to that the portion of earth that made up of waters, including the ocean, lake, rivers, streams, glaciers, and the underground water. Less than 3% of water of earth is a fresh water. Among that include polar, ice caps, glaciers, groundwater, surface water, reservoir, fresh water, lake, even the atmosphere of water. However, the amount of fresh water is usable by peoples and other member of biosphere is less than 0.7%. The total of this water are the river and lake in there. That is nothing but the how much water are the in the earth and what we called as that is called as a hydrosphere, near about the only 3% water are the fresh water. Out of human and the other member of biosphere are using only the 0.7% water. Then fresh water resources, surface and the ground water. we have know that a different form of resources. That may be a freshwater resources, groundwater resources, or anything else. The available freshwater resources, either groundwater or a surface water. That may be a river or a lake. Water flow on the surface of the land is a surface runoff. The relationship among the surface runoff, precipitation, evaporation, and the percolation summarized in the following equation. Surface runoff is equal to precipitation minus evaporation plus percolations. That is nothing but the how water will be flow in the nature or the atmosphere. When the surface runoff resulting to rainfall, surface water will be runoff resulting into rainfall. Rainfall or the snow melt. Confirm the relativity of a narrow well-defined channel is called as a river or a streams. Groundwater is the that water that has a percolate downward through the soil and present within the porous spaces in a soil. Porous spaces in a soil or the bedrock. It has been estimated that the global groundwater resource is equivalent to the about 34 times of the volume of surface water of the world. These resources present nearly everywhere and has additional advantages. Typically need no need of storage, treatment, utilization does require the construction, as well as sometime presenting the problems in the most needy equation. Okay, that are the water resources. That may be fresh, that may be ground, or that may be underground water. Let's see water consumption. Where the water consume or the consumed by the different activity or the human. In that, water consumption varies greatly among the region due to the difference in economic development. The average municipal uses of United States about the 150 gallon per person per day, through a rate of higher than the 350 gallons in some location. This is include the home use, bathing, waste disposal and gardening, as well as institutional commercial usage per capita per person. The water usage in Asia is only 22 gallons per day, just 12 gallons in Africa. That is nothing but the water usage by the that country, that area, along that is a human by the different activity. The goals of water conservation effort include, there are different goals they have made. That means why needed to conserve and how we can conserve by the goal achieving that conservation. Ensuring the availability of water for the future generation, where the withdrawal fresh water from the ecosystem does not exceed the natural replacement rate. That is the first thing we have to goal. That is, we have to do. The production will be not replenishable. Production rate and the usage rate we have to manage. First thing of water conservation goal, that is we have to achieve. Then goal number second, the energy conservation, water pumping, delivery, wastewater treatment facility consume significant amount of energy. In some region world over the 15%, the total electricity consumption is devoted to the water management. So that is the uses and the human activity we also have to manage. For example, in some area there are 15% electricity are needed. In such area we have to not create more electricity by using the water or the any type of resources. Habitat conservation, where the minimizing the human water use the help preserve fresh water habitat for the local wildlife and migrating the water flow waterfall, but also the water quality. So that is the most important. We have to conserve the habitat of wildlife on the fresh water, and water flow also we have to maintain. Then strategies of water conservation. There are the key activities.
any beneficial reduction of water loss, use and the waste resources, avoiding the any damages to the water quality, improving the water management, practices that reduces the use or the enhance the beneficial use of water. Then conservation management of water. That are the, we have see the goals and some strategies. Now see conservation and the management of water. How we can do conservation and the management of water. As we know, the water is the basic need of a living organism, and acute crisis of water expected following some regions, the world, particularly in our country. The shortage of water shall make a many location barren, dry, devoid of lives. Fertile lands make a many localities barren, dry, devoid life. Fertile land will convert into the desert. Conservation of water is therefore the absolutely necessary today. So water is needed by the every organism. So conservation are needed. Then next, a number of steps are being undertaken to minimize the wastage of fresh water resources and make more efficient use of available. Number of things are going running to using the minimum fresh water for the minimum fresh water conservation. So that have applied to all type of resources of water. That may be a marine water, that may be surface, that may be underground water. Let's see main approaches to management of water are follows. Which approaches we have to follow the during the management of water resources? The construction of dams and the reservoirs regulate the year around the supply of water. They are also helpful for the controlling the floods and generating electricity. Desalinizing the seawater, saline groundwater, making it fit for drinking or the agriculture purpose. Desalinize the plant are already under the operation in a Middle East country. That is main important characters. We have to make a desalination of a saline source of water, that means which are not available for the human use, but we can do some projects, plants, and they are desalinated. Salt concentration we can be reduced. In this way we can control that or the water can be used more amount, but only once desalination condition. Diversion of water and the bodies. Diversion of water and the bodies, for example through canals, increase the natural supply of water, for example in a particular area. That is the most important things. In some area water resources are not available of nature, so that we have convert them water bodies and make useful for the human. Then regular breeding, regular degrading and the distillation water bodies, that also we have to do. Then some projects and the policy are running. That one of that is a Swajal Dhara. Swajal Dhara, that is one most activity of government. Reforms in the rural drinking water sectors were the adopted in 1999, and also few projects were the launched as pilots. They were the intended to be implemented during the 95-year plans, and with experience gain on the reform year plan. With the experience gain with on a reform initiative, whereby firms the scale up the during the 10th plan period, adopting the demand response strategies, and also institutionalization, community participation for the sustainability of a drinking water supply system and the sources of a rural areas. That is nothing but the areas and their water conservation strategy. Then efficient water utilization efforts. How we can efficiently water utilization efforts we can do. The subsurface irrigation is an emerging technology with high water utilization efficiency. Subsurface irrigation uses the drip irrigation, tubing buried 6 to 8 inches underground with a spacing 12 to 24 inches between the parallel lines. The tubing contains drip outlet, delivery of water nutrient within the
root zone and a desired rate. In addition of water conservation, subsurface irrigation has other advantages. Then the overhead sprinkler do not minimal overwatering, fewer diseases and the aeration problem, less runoff, erosion, fewer weed and the better protection to the from the Wanda slim. However, this system is relatively expensive to the install. That is nothing but how we can water will be managed. With minimum water, we can do the more crop production. Then next is the water crisis, past and future. Which type of crisis will be arises in now condition and the future will be arising. The water you drink today has likely around one form or another since the dinosaur roams the earth 100 million years ago. While the amount of fresh water on the planet remain fairly constant over a time, continuously recycled through atmospheres and back into our cups of population will be exploded. This meaning that is every year competition for the clean, copious supply of drinking water, cooking, bathing and the sustaining life is intensified. The water scarcity is an abstract of a concept of a many and the stark reality for other. It is the result of a myriad environment, political, economic and the social forces. The fresh water make up a very small fraction of all water on the planet, while nearly 70% of the world covered by water, only 2.5% that is fresh. And rest is saline, which is made of ocean and the sea. Next, even then the just 1% of fresh water easily accessible, with much of it trapped by the glaciers and the snowfalls. The in essence of only 0.007% planet water are available to the fuels and the feed to the 6.8 billion peoples. Water is a life. Everyone know that the importance of water, and we also consider as the water name as a life. Why? Because wherever there are the people need water to survive, not only the human body, 60% water resources is also essential for the producing the food, clothing and computer, moving our waste streams and keeping an environment healthy. So that is the water act as a life. Unfortunately, human have proved that to be inefficient water users. The average hamburger takes 2400 liters or the 630 gallons of water to the produce, and many water intensive crops such as cotton are grown in arid regions. Then causes of that crisis, how their crisis will be arises. Their first, water pollution is the most important reason due to which different type of water getting polluted and that are not using by human. So that is the one most cause. Most of the sources of water in rural areas are the terrible polluted due to the poor sanitation, lack of a waste treatment plant. Overall level of a global pollutant are having the negative effect on a drinking of water that currently clean as the time go. On this damage will be exacerbated. Then groundwater overdrafting, that is second. The excessive use of groundwater, our agriculture industry is leading to the diminished yield of wasted water. Over 70% of water used to the grow crops and most are the wasted due to the leaky pipes and the poor watering techniques. So that is the overdrafting. Then overuse and the misuse. That leads to the more water wasted by the squander and the pointless reasons, leads to the further escalation of the crisis. One of the single hamburger that is take the 630 gallon water to the produce. Then some diseases also responsible. Which are diseases? A large quantity of available groundwater in the worst effect in the parts of the world is ridden the diseases due to the lack of proper treatment and the recycling. Then
another reason that is climate change. It is the most important factors that changing the way of a water evaporate and where it rains, pushing rainfalls and the further south in both hemispheres. That is the most important climate reason. There is no fixed timing of raining, there is no fixed timing of evaporating, there is no fixed timing of snowfall. So there is a wastage of water will be condensed, and in the future there will be a one most crisis. Then mismanagement, improper training, education leads to the needless waste of a safe clean water every day, as well as overuse areas that don't require so much water. Corruption, simply put, some peoples who have the power help to those peoples need don't cares. That means corruption, it is the most important factors. It is also in a water conservation. Then lack of institution. The lesser developed country have no institution to the advise on water treatment or the management. This lead to the mismanagement and the waste. So that is institution is important. There is no need, there is no availability of guidance and how water will manage, how water will be conserved. Then lack of infrastructure. The poor regions often don't have funds, educations and the implementation proper infrastructure such as a waste treatment, recycling plant. So that is the one most reason that make a crisis in the future. Then loss of groundwater due to the climate change, human expansion and the development leading to the loss of groundwater in the worldwide. Then effect of a water crisis. What are the effect will be we have to face? First, there is a diseases, death and lack of sanitation that we have to face due to the water crisis. Let's see, all life need a water 90 second. Every 90 second child dies from the water related to illness and illness diseases. That is a death. Every 90 second human body will be require water. If that I will not give, that death will be possible to that child. Then diseases. Some waterborne diseases will be spread due to the water quality and the water health. So that is important. Then warfare. The regional conflict arises due to the loss of water sources. Lack of irrigation. Without water, farmer can't grow the crops, which leads to the death of nearly 1 million people every year. Lack of sanitation, which leads to the diseases and causes the countless health issue and leads the diseases. Then lack of hygiene. Due to water cannot available, we cannot maintain the hygiene, that means cleaning efforts. Then agriculture problems. We know that is every crops in the farm, they require the water for their growth and development. Then livestock problems. There are the production of that livestock or the feedstock. We have to production due to the water. If water cannot possible, if water is not available, the production of livestock, it is also impossible and the problems arises. Then malnutrition. Every type of food in the country, preparation is require the water. And if that water are not available, the food stock will be not prepared and the death or the problems arises like malnutrition. Then birth defect. In the human, during the most of birth babies are due to the require the water for their growth and development. If that water are not available, so in the future we have to, future and the past, we have to same that problem, that is a birth defect. Then poor education. Most of the school worst affected areas do not have toilets and the safe drinking water for the student. Such leave the student dehydrated, mentally incapable to achieving the well school. So that is also effect on the education. Then effect of crisis on the environment. That means effect not only the human or the economy or the country, it is also affect on the environment. Increase in salinity due to the overuse of water, evaporation, that leads to the salinity. So there is in the fresh water that is converted into the salinity will be increases. Then nutrient pollution. Then algal growth causes the excessive nutrient in a groundwater, tending to the more water being the unsafe drink for the high levels and the nitrates. So that is the most important things, that water are will be very beneficial. So everywhere. So that is if that water will not available, the algal growth will stop and the nutrient will be more in that water. So that salinity will be increases. The loss of floodplains due to the human expansion leads to the drying riverwards, loss of the habitat. The drying riverwards due to the poor agriculture practices and the human expansion leads to the habitat and the less water access in poor region. Then loss of habitat also relays. For example, in the forest, there are continuous of water. That means evergreen forest are there. But due to the some reason, there is a raining is too much low. So there is a loss of their habitat will be a possible. Then subsidence cause and the loss of groundwater leads to the landslips and the sinkholes. That is known as a water irrigation. Then solution of a water crisis. What are the solution we get? First, we have to charities. We have to make a charities. Charity, that means a charity shows awareness related to the water we have to do. And from the charities, we have to collect the funds. And from that funding, we have to develop some water conservation strategy. Then spreading and the message, new technology and the improve irrigation. That all things we have to do to that crisis will be not arises. Then water pricing. Human have no value of water. So that is the water price we have to understand to the humans. Then only we can know the value of that water. Ultimately that water will be a resource and sustainably used by the human. Energy efficient desalination plant. I have explained. Desalination, that is a saline condition converted into the usable condition or the fresh water. So such plant we have to establish, due to which salination will be removed. Rainwater harvesting. Rainwater, most of the rainwater, there is no harvesting technology, or the if any technology they use up to 8 to 10 days, but after that will be lost, there is no use. So we have to develop the technology, rainwater harvesting, that is the fresh water and that also used for the human activity. Then address the pollution. We have to solve the problems related to the pollution. In such area there are or industrial area more polluted water will be a discharge in the different water bodies. So that problems also we have to solve. Then only we have to get a solution. Then next, population and growth control. There is no any problems to solve the nature availability or the resource control, but there is only one there is control, that is the population and their growth. If more population they using the more resources, and due to the more resources they wasted the more resources, so there is a population and the growth will be very short. Then use minimum resources, use minimum wastage of that resources will be done. Then climate change. The expert says that is a decreasing the effect of a global warming and the pursuing the clean energy that will turn to help water crisis. We find a new technology of water safe and the use. Okay, this is about today's lectures related to the groundwater as a resources. If you have any doubts related to the groundwater resources, please comment below the section. Do like, share and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.